Hey everyone! In this video, we're going to set up our own VPN server from scratch, with a nice web UI for managing clients, two-factor authentication, and automatic updates. And we're going to do all of that in less than 5 minutes. How, you might ask? Well, magic of Ansible, of course. If you already have a VPS and want to skip right to the tutorial, here's the timecode. I've made a video 2 years ago in which I showed you guys how to set up your own VPN, and it was pretty long and very complicated. So I decided to automate and optimize a lot of things, and this is what came out of it. This is the Ansible playbook that I wrote, and unlike some of the popular VPN scripts out there that only handle the VPN functionality itself, it also configures automatic updates on your system, creates a non-root user, hardens SSH access and even generates SSH keys for you if you don't have any, sets up fail to ban and UFW, and finally configures WG Easy, Othelia, and Bunker Web for secure WireGuard web UI protected by two-factor authentication. So it's basically an all-in-one solution that automates the whole process of setting up your own VPN from scratch. And the only thing that you'll need to do is fill in your own data before running the playbook. Now I do want to mention one more thing before we start. This is going to be a purely practical guide. I don't care what you will be doing with your own VPN, and I trust that you're smart enough to know why you would want to use one and in which cases you don't actually need one. But just in case you want to know more, the first part of my 2020 video still holds true, so go and check it out. With that out of the way, let's get started. Let's start with choosing a VPS. There are a lot of popular VPS providers out there like Linode, DigitalOcean, or Hetzner. And even though the big players definitely have their own advantages, the servers they offer cost a lot compared to a typical VPN service subscription. Instead, we're going to take a look at some cheaper options, and for that we're going to use a website called lowendstock.com. Here you can rent a VPS for the same price per year as you would pay for a month of DigitalOcean or Linode. But before we start searching for a dream VPS, we need to filter out offers that are not going to work for us. First of all, we need a dedicated IPv4 address. A lot of cheaper VPSs only offer a NAT IPv4 address, which basically means that you'll be sharing your IP with multiple people. And while that might sound good in terms of privacy, it's pretty much guaranteed that when you try to use your VPN for torrenting completely legal Linux ISOs, you'll realize that your IP is banned on most trackers. Second, virtualization technology. I won't get into details here, just know that OVZ is bad and KVM is good. Everything else is probably going to be too costly anyway. Third, bandwidth. That's how much traffic in gigabytes you're allowed to push through your server per month. Some servers will have unlimited bandwidth, which is good, and some might have as little as 500 gigs. Depending on how intensively you plan to use the server, you might want to go for unlimited bandwidth, if possible. Last but not least, location. Don't pick Germany or Austria, obviously, unless you want to get slapped with a fine for torrenting. Also, probably don't pick Russia, since there is always a risk of FSB seizing all 10 terabytes of your hand-picked Shrek Rule 34 content. Now let's sort by price and see what we can choose. This server in Romania looks pretty good. It costs $12 a year, has 1.5 GB of RAM, but only has 100 megabit uplink. At the moment of filming, there was an even cheaper offer on VPS from RackNerd, with 768 megabytes of RAM, a 1 gigabit uplink, and a terabyte of monthly traffic, which is what I ended up getting for this video. By the time you're watching this, the list will probably be completely different, so just go through it by yourself and see what makes sense for you. For what it's worth, no VPS provider has paid to be in this video or sponsored it in any way. So after adding our VPS to the shopping cart and choosing the latest version of Ubuntu as the OS, we need to enter our obviously very real name and address. Keep in mind though that some providers will literally ask for a copy of your ID before you can even start using the server, so make sure to read the terms and services before actually paying money. At this point, some servers will also let you set a root password, which means that you won't have to set your password after the first login. When it comes to payment, a lot of providers let you pay with cryptocurrency, which is nice, but do keep in mind that oftentimes crypto transactions can still be traced back to you, so don't do anything stupid, dangerous, or illegal. So after you paid for your server, you'll get an email from the provider with the login information. Most of the time, this process is automated, but sometimes it can take a few hours for the email to arrive. Now we have to log into our server, and for that, we need to open a terminal application. On macOS and Linux-based operating systems, you can do that by opening your application launcher and searching for terminal. And on Windows, you can open the Start menu and search for PowerShell. I'm going to be using iTerm. Now let's log into our server by typing SSH root at server IP address. Answer yes to the fingerprint question, and after that it will ask us for the password, so let's copy-paste that. By the way, the actual symbols won't be shown as you type, and that's going to be the case for pretty much all passwords in this tutorial. Also, tech tip, on Windows, you can paste into PowerShell by right-clicking in the terminal window. Once you're done, press enter and you're going to be presented with a command shell. First thing we need to do immediately is change the root password. There are thousands of Chinese bots scanning the entire internet for open SSH servers with common passwords. And unless you want to become a part of the great Xi Jinping botnet, type passwd and enter your password of choice twice, pressing enter after each password. If you have already set your password while buying the VPS, you can skip this step. That was basically the most difficult part of this tutorial. Now we need to execute the installation script. For that, just go to the GitHub page that I'm going to link in the description and copy-paste this command. Now, running random untrusted scripts from the internet is probably not the best idea, so make sure to read this script or have somebody else read it. I've tried to add a lot of comments though, so hopefully it's not too cryptic. After that's done, we can copy and paste this command and press enter. This is going to update all the packages on our system, install Ansible, and clone the repository containing the playbook. Depending on your internet speed, this might take a while, but eventually you should see this screen. Before actually running the playbook, we need to fill in some information, starting with our username of choice. I'm gonna go with notthebe, as usual, then a password, we'll need to enter it twice. Next, the installer is going to ask us for a domain name. If you don't already have one, you can use DuckDNS. It's a free dynamic DNS service, very simple to use. You just log in with your GitHub account, create a domain, and point it to the IP address of the VPS, which you can find either in the email that you got from the provider or in the control panel of the VPS. If you're using your own domain instead, make sure that it already points to the correct IP address. This will be important for generating certificates. Next, the installer is going to ask us whether we already have an SSH key that we would like to use. And I'm gonna say,
hell no, I know you're smoking that pack.
Last but not least, we need to choose whether to set up the email functionality. Now this is completely optional, but if you want to get email notifications about automatic updates, banned IPs and such, you can set it up now. We're not gonna do it though. Now we just have to enter our desired vault password. Vault is basically an encrypted file storing your passwords. Once you've entered it twice, it should be good to go. So let's press Y and enter. The script is going to set up the VPN now, which once again might take a few minutes. If you're setting this up on Ubuntu 22.04, you might see a big scary error message in between, but don't worry about it, this is completely normal. After that's done, you're going to see this screen. First thing we need to do is copy the generated SSH key to our host machine. I'm gonna copy this command right here, open a new terminal window, and paste the command. Keep in mind that it's already going to have the actual username and the IP address of your server here, so no need to replace that. I'm gonna enter my password, and as you can see, the key has been copied. Next, we're going to test if the key works. Let's copy the next command, go to the other terminal window, and paste it. As you can see, the prompt says enter passphrase for key, and we're able to log in successfully. Now let's go back to our server, and as we can see, it says return to this terminal window and press enter. Your system will reboot to install kernel updates. So let's press enter and wait for a couple of minutes.
6 hours later.
Okay, so the 2 minutes have passed, and now we can try logging back into our server. I'm gonna copy this command, paste it over here, and press enter. And after entering your password, you should see this command prompt. That's good. Now let's navigate to this URL in the browser. This is gonna take us to the login screen. Just use the same login and password that you used for logging into SSH. And now we have to set up our second factor. Let's press register device, and Athelia is gonna tell us that an email has been sent to your address. That's a bit misleading because we didn't set up the email functionality. Instead, we're gonna go back to our terminal and type show_2FA. You'll see a link, let's go to that link, and here you'll see a QR code. To scan the code, we'll need a phone and a TOTP application. Now, if you already know how to use TOTP, you probably have an app that you like, but if you don't, you can just use Aegis on Android or OTP Auth on iOS. The workflow is gonna be very similar for all apps, and I'm gonna be using OTP Auth on my phone. So I'm gonna open the app, click on the plus button, scan barcode with camera, and that's it. Now we just need to press done in the web UI and enter the 6-digit code from the phone. After that's done, it should be automatically redirected to the WireGuard web UI. And that's pretty much it when it comes to the server part. Now I'm gonna show you how to configure the VPN on your devices. I'm gonna explain how to set up the VPN on iOS, but the process is gonna be very similar for Android devices. First off, we need to create a new peer in the web UI. Press on the new client button and enter a name for your peer. I'm gonna call it Wolfgang's iPhone. Then we're gonna click on the QR button, and that's pretty much it for the server part. Now let's switch to our phone. First, we need to install the WireGuard app from the App Store or Google Play if you're on Android. Once the app is installed, I'm gonna open it, tap on Add Tunnel, and then choose Create from QR Code. Once the code is scanned, we're gonna need to name it. I'm gonna call it Wolfgang's VPN. And finally, we need to allow the WireGuard app to set up the VPN tunnel by entering our passcode. This is a one-time process. And that's it. Now let's connect to the VPN and check our IP address. As you can see, it worked, and my phone now has an American IP address. On desktop, the process is going to be slightly different. Let's go back to the web UI and add another peer. I'm going to call this one Wolfgang's Mac. Now, instead of pressing on the QR button, I'm going to press on this button, and that's going to download the VPN configuration file to my computer. Just like on a mobile, to use the VPN config, we'll need to install the app. And you can check out the instructions for your platform on the official WireGuard website, wireguard.com/install. Since I'm on Mac, I'm going to press on download from App Store. Since I already have it installed, I'm just going to click on open. Here we can import our config by pressing on the plus button and clicking import tunnel from file. I'm going to choose the config file that we just downloaded, and now I'm going to press on activate. We're now connected to the VPN. Once again, I'm going to go back to the browser and check my IP. As you can see, it matches the IP of my VPS, so we're all set. So that's it. We just set up our own VPN server with automatic updates, two-factor authentication, and a super easy web UI for managing clients. If you have any issues or questions about the playbook, leave a comment down below, or better yet, submit an issue on GitHub, and I'll try to answer that as soon as possible. But yeah, that's gonna be it for this video, and as usual, I do want to thank my patrons. Mitchell Valentino, James Uppington, Primus, Carlos Banilla, Ramos Ilyesh, David Love, Robots Dream of Crypto, Catherine DC, and everybody else who supports this channel. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.